More than 43 million American families own a dog, and for their owners, love is unconditional. But now science is helping us learn if the feeling is mutual. Of course, we think it is. Terrell Brown is with us. Terrell, good morning.
Hey, good morning to you, Nora. When a team of researchers at Atlanta's Emory University set out to discover what goes on inside a dog's head, their first problem was finding a dog that would sit still long enough for the experiment.
At the King residence outside Atlanta, their dog, Katie, is one of the family.
Ready? Go get it.
Whether playing with the kids or settling in for a nap, Katie appears to love the Kings as much as they love her. But what's the real feeling behind those big eyes and wagging tail?
You gotta wonder, do they just see the person that's gonna feed them and walk them and give them what they want, or do they truly love us?
To find out, owner Patricia King volunteered Katie for a research study at Emory University. Led by neurologist Gregory Burns, the goal was to see if dogs feel emotion the same way humans do. Burns has spent his career using MRI brain scans to study decision-making in humans, but it had never been used on dogs. Among the problems, they need to be awake and remain still for the noisy and claustrophobic procedure.
They're coffin-like spaces, they're incredibly loud, and you have to hold still within millimeters.
That's where Katie came in. To block out the noise, she learned how to wear special earmuffs and was trained to remain perfectly still. Once in place, the team took brain scans of Katie while she was given commands and shown food like hot dogs, first by a stranger and then by her owner.
We're trying to sort out how she's responding, not just to the signals, but who's giving the signals.
What Burns found was that in one key part of the brain, dogs react with emotions like love and attachment, the same way humans do.
So when you see Katie's MRI on a screen, what do we learn about her?
I mean, it is clearly most active when she's getting signals from Patricia, her human.
And so what do you draw from that?
It's more than hot dogs.
And that Katie loves Patricia?
Sure, why not? It's not unreasonable to have a dog version of that.
Burns has documented his findings in a new book called How Dogs Love Us. As for Patricia King and her family, the results of the study only confirmed what they already knew.
We all just want to be loved, and just to know that our dog might have the same feelings, I think it would enhance our bond, and we just see them as a little bit more like us.
Dr. Burns hopes that his findings will convince lawmakers to revise existing laws that would give animals the same level of protection as children.
We're all thinking, did they need a study for this?
Duh, right?
Duh, exactly. Yeah.
Who was the president? Somebody in Washington said, if you want a friend, get a dog.
Truman.
Yeah, that's absolutely true.
Yeah.
Very nice.
The nice thing about dogs, they don't talk back, right?
Right.
And it's unconditional love.
And they just look at that, you're like, you know, you're the greatest thing in the world.
Yes, we love Barbie.
And we need that. Yeah.